Let's take a look at this limit. The limit as h goes to 0 of 1 over 7 plus h minus 1 seventh all over h. Okay, so let's try and think ahead a little bit and picture what's going to happen if we work through this limit and get an answer. So what's going to happen on top? Well, I'm going to end up plugging in 0 for h eventually, right? And so I'm going to get 1 seventh minus 1 seventh. So that's going to give me 0 on top when I take the limit. Now what about on the bottom? Well, I just have the limit as h goes to 0 of h. So that's also going to give me 0 on the bottom. So we see that if we were to try to take this limit in its current form, we would end up getting 0 over 0, which is a form that we can't work with. What that tells us, whenever we get 0 over 0 for a limit, that tells us we need to do more algebra of some sort. Okay, and so in this video, we're going to go over another algebraic technique that can be useful for working with these 0 over 0 limits. The technique we're going to learn in this video is common denominators. So often when you have a limit that looks like this one, where there's either fractions in the top or could be fractions in the bottom as well, it's sometimes useful to combine those fractions by finding a common denominator, and that'll often cause some things to simplify. So let me show you what I mean. Okay, so let me rewrite this. Okay, so let's look at what that common denominator in the top is going to be. So the common denominator is just going to be the product of the two denominators. So the common denominator is going to be 7 times 7 plus h. Okay, so we want to rewrite both of those fractions so that they have that common denominator. So the first fraction is going to need to be multiplied by 7 over 7 in order to have that denominator we want. And then the second fraction is going to be multiplied by 7 plus h over 7 plus h. Okay, so notice that if we canceled out those factors we just added in, we would get back to the original problem. So we haven't changed the problem in any way. We've just rewritten it. Okay, so now this is what we have. So now that we have a common denominator on top, we can actually combine those fractions into one fraction. So on the top, I'm going to get 7 minus 7 minus h. So be careful there. You need to distribute the subtraction sign to both terms. So 7 minus 7 minus h. And that's all over the common denominator, 7 times 7 plus h. And this is still all over h. Okay, so now we see that we can do a little bit of simplification because I have 7 over 7 in the top of my numerator. So this becomes negative h over 7 times 7 plus h, and that's all over h. Okay, so what should we do next? Let's deal with this fraction within a fraction mess, because that's just kind of messy to work with. So if you remember back from when you learned fractions, dividing by a fraction is the same as multiplying by its reciprocal. So a way I can simplify this is write negative h over 7 times 7 plus h times, so I've got h in the bottom, I'm going to multiply by its reciprocal, 1 over h. Okay, now what this allows us to do is see that this h cancels, right? I have a factor of h in the top and a factor of h in the bottom. So I cancel out those h's. And I'm allowed to do that because I'm looking at the limit as h goes to 0. I don't care what's actually happening at h equals 0 because this function is not defined there, right? It was 0 over 0. But I'm looking at the limit as h goes to 0, so I can simplify the function like this, and the limit will still be the same. Okay, so we're pretty much done now. Now we've got the limit as h goes to 0 of negative 1 in the top over 7 times 7 plus h. So now that we've simplified this a good deal, let's try to use our limit laws to find the value. Okay, so I've got a quotient. So this is going to be the limit as h goes to 0 of negative 1 on top. And then on the bottom, I've got several pieces, right? I've got a product, and then I've also got a sum. So I'm just going to go ahead and split those things up all in one step. So this is going to be the limit as h goes to 0 of 7 times the limit as h goes to 0 of 7 plus the limit as h goes to 0 of h. Okay, so on top, I've just got the limit of a constant, so that's just going to be negative 1. Okay, on the bottom, once again, the limit of a constant. Don't know where that 0 came from. Okay, just the limit of a constant, 7. So that's just going to be 7. And then 7, again, plus the limit as h goes to 0 of h is just 0. Okay, so that's negative 1 over 49 as our final answer. Okay, super quick summary really quick. What did we do here? This is just another algebraic technique for dealing with a situation where we get 0 over 0 for our limit. And what we did is we worked with those fractions in the top to combine them by finding a common denominator. And once we did that, it allowed us to do a lot of simplification. So this is a technique that is very useful.